One of the most important factors when it comes to mining is where you do it. You need to pay attention to several aspects: infrastructure, electricity costs, climate, political stability. There are several hotspots for mining worldwide, but because we want to stay ahead of the market, we are constantly scouting new locations. In the past few years, we've mastered this process, and Sweden is one of the results of those efforts. When we scouted for locations quite a while ago, before we started building this farm, we noticed that here in Sweden, many great factors come together to make a really great mining location. First of all, the political system is very stable and welcoming to cryptocurrencies and cryptocurrency mining. Also, the general infrastructure is just very well built out. Sweden has great roads, great airport infrastructure. It's in the EU, so imports and exports are kind of easy to handle. Internet connectivity is great, everything's very well connected with glass fiber and all the good stuff. A very important topic when you're building a data center is how the cooling is going to work. Sweden has a very mild and quite cold climate, so it's great to build a cooling system with it. And last but not least, the power here is very good. This farm is completely hydropowered. Which actually is not so much of a surprise. Usually renewable energy sources are quite plentiful. So when you're starting a cryptocurrency mining operation or anything else that uses a lot of power, being close to a renewable energy source, for example, a hydropower dam, is extremely beneficial, because where there's a lot of power and the price of power is good, that's where cryptocurrency miners also want to be. We're really happy to do this video now about our new Sweden operation, and we're really proud to show it. We're usually not quite that open about our mining locations. We've showed a lot of footage about our Iceland location. Obviously, we have a lot of other locations also worldwide that we don't talk about quite so publicly. I'd quickly like to point out why that is. Please understand that we have to walk a fine line between showing our facilities and keeping them secret. On the one hand, we want to be as open and transparent about our operations as possible, to show people what we're doing, to show our customers what they're actually putting their money towards, just to give a general impression to people what cryptocurrency mining is all about. So we think of it as an educational aspect and as a trust building aspect also, so we can show people what we're all about. On the other hand, we need to be careful about protecting our intellectual property. We need to worry about people stealing our ideas and copying them for themselves. We need to worry about our effort spent towards some technology or some infrastructure improvement or something just being ripped off and we're losing the benefit we get from that. We also need to worry about security aspects. If we show people all the locations that we're at, we'll have people knocking at our door asking for free tours. And that's actually happened in Iceland, by the way. That actually does happen. People knock on our gates and they ask to come in. They can't come in, but they still come. And we obviously don't want that extra security concern on too many other locations. The most secure site is something that is when no one knows about it, of course.